In this video, we are going to create such a Fibonacci object here on our chart. So let's see how we can do that with MQL5.
In this video, we are going to create an expert advisor that calculates and draws a Fibonacci retracement on the chart based on the highest and lowest prices of the last 100 candles. Let's see how we can do that. We start Metaeditor by clicking the little icon or pressing F4. First, we create variables for the highest and lowest candles. Then, we create arrays to store the highest and lowest prices. We sort these arrays in descending order from the current candle. Next, we fill the arrays with data for the last 100 candles using the CopyHigh and CopyLow functions. The CopyHigh function fills the high array with the highest prices of the last 100 candles, and the CopyLow function fills the low array with the lowest prices of the last 100 candles. We then calculate the highest and lowest candles using the ArrayMaximum and ArrayMinimum functions. ArrayMaximum returns the index of the highest value in the high array, and ArrayMinimum returns the index of the lowest value in the low array. We create an array for price data using the MQL rates structure, which holds information about prices. We sort this array from the current candle to the oldest candle. The copy rates function copies price data into the price information array. The parameters for copy rates are the symbol, period, starting position, and the number of bars. Next, we delete any former Fibonacci object on the chart using object delete. We then create a new Fibonacci object using object create. The parameters for object create are the symbol, object name, object type, window number, and the coordinates for the Fibonacci levels, chain. The coordinates are determined by the time and price of the highest and lowest candles. We retrieve the values of the Fibonacci object using object get integer and object get double. Object get integer retrieves the time of the Fibonacci levels, and object get double retrieves the price levels. We calculate the 50% Fibonacci level by averaging the 0% and 100% levels. Finally, we create a chart output using the comment function to display the time and price levels of the Fibonacci retracement. We press F7 to compile the code. If this was too fast for you, or if you don't understand what all the code is doing, you may want to check out the premium course on our website or watch one of the basic videos first. If the compilation works, we go back to Metaeditor by pressing F4 or clicking on the icon. Back in Metaeditor, we press Ctrl and R to start the strategy tester, pick the expert advisor that we have just created, enable the visual mode, and start a strategy test. We should see the expert advisor on the chart. If you are already a premium course member and have an idea for a video like this one, you can send us an email. In this video, we have learned how to create an expert advisor that calculates and draws a Fibonacci retracement on the chart using a few lines of MQL code. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.
Okay, I hope by now you can see the Fibonacci object on your chart. If this was too fast for you, or if you have no idea what all the code is doing, maybe the premium course might be interesting for you. You can find it on our website. For now, I say thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.